Next, I'm going to talk about an inflationary gap. We start with our economy operating at its potential GDP. So suppose the potential GDP is $500 billion, and our aggregate expenditure is equal to our output, meaning our economy is in equilibrium. And this is a good equilibrium because our actual GDP is equal to potential GDP, meaning we have full employment and there is no cyclical unemployment. Now we're ready to talk about our inflationary gap. By definition, the inflationary gap is equal to the amount of expenditure cut needed in order to restore our GDP back to its potential. So supposing in our economy, we have consumers trying to buy too much goods, more than the producers can produce. And as a result, we're going to have an inflation. So you can see that our aggregate expenditure, AE, is going to move up from AE1 to AE2. And as a result, our actual GDP is going to be higher than our potential GDP, and we have an inflation. And in our example, our actual GDP is $540 billion, and our potential GDP is $500. So we want our GDP to go down by $40 billion. And therefore, we need to cut aggregate expenditure. But by how much? By exactly the amount of inflationary gap. And we can calculate that. Inflationary gap is equal to the desired reduction in GDP divided by the expenditure multiplier. So in our example, we want our GDP to go down by $40 billion. And our expenditure multiplier is equal to 2. Therefore, your inflationary gap is equal to 40 divided by 2, and that gives you $20 billion.